And Darren, according to a psychologist that was brought in by the defense and did a series of tests on Joshua Komisarzewski, he told the jury today that Komisarzewski cannot handle stress, cannot handle complex problems, has an inflated view of his abilities, and as we have learned, engages in risky behavior. His resume seems as long as a college textbook. Dr. Leo Shea was called by Joshua Komisarzewski's defense team Wednesday morning to discuss his psychoanalysis of their client. Shea says Komisarzewski has mental health issues due to sexual abuse as a child. He said he was tortured, having a series of concussions that started at age 9, and also heavy drug abuse. But he did tell the jury that the defendant has above average intelligence. But the state went on the attack. Although Shea says Komisarzewski is a poor planner and doesn't handle stress well, attorney Michael Dearington pointed out poor planning didn't stop Komisarzewski from entering the Pettit home. Now, before Shea took the stand, the jury heard from a variety of witnesses relating to Komisarzewski's roof repair job he did the day before the home invasion. Michael Rano was a supervisor for Brunetto Construction, the company Komisarzewski worked for that day. He testified that he met up with Komisarzewski on the 23rd at the Cheshire Stop and Shop to pay him for his work. A surveillance photo shows him at the ATM withdrawing cash as Komisarzewski waits next to him. It's the same store Komisarzewski spotted Jennifer Hawk Pettit and Michaela later, following them home. Also on the stand today was a man who sold roofing supplies. And of course, the idea there by the defense is the fact that many roofing supplies contain petroleum products, possibly explaining why there was a petroleum-like product, gasoline, found on Komisarzewski's clothes following the Cheshire home invasion. Now, the hope was that the defense would wrap this up today, but Michael Dearington, the state's attorney, is not done with his cross-examination yet of Dr. Shea, so we are back in court tomorrow. Hopefully, everything will be wrapped up, and then court resumes on Tuesday, which should be closing arguments and then the jury charge. We're live in New Haven. I'm Jamie Muro, News 8.